Which way?
The glory to Jesus. As you're listening.
You'll never find a hairline like mine.
The Bible says in the book of Isaiah, chapter 40, it says, comfort, yes, comfort my people. Speak to my people comforts and say to them, your warfare is ended, your iniquities are pardoned. For you have received from the Lord's hand double for your sins. The voice of one crying in the wilderness, prepare the way of the Lord. Make straight in the desert a pathway for our God. Let every valley be brought up high, exalted. Let every hill and mountain be brought low. Let the crooked ways be made straight, and the rough ways be made smooth. And then the glory of the Lord shall be revealed, and all flesh shall see it together. The glory of God is going to be revealed. All flesh will see it together. Bible says when Jesus, he said, when I come back, he said, I will come back on the clouds of heaven. He says, all flesh shall see me, he says, even those that pierce me. He says that everybody, every nation will mourn because of Jesus' return. Oh, even so, Lord, come. I say Jesus Christ, of the seed of David. It said he was born according to the flesh, but it says that he was declared to be the Son of God with power, according to the Spirit of holiness. I know the Holy Spirit. You know, the Spirit that's out here is not holy. The Spirit that out here isn't agreed with the whole of the Spirit of Christ. The testimony of Jesus Christ, the Spirit of holiness, separation from sinners. You know, my wife quoted a scripture out of Hebrews chapter 7 earlier. For such a high priest was fitting for us, who was holy, harmless, undefiled, and separate from sinners. Jesus is separate from sinners. You're a sinner out here. Jesus is separate from you. He's not approving of you. He's not walking with you out here. He's crying out to you for you to turn back. The bridge is out. Your sin bridge is out, man. You're continuing in your pornography, continuing in your masturbation. What do you think the Holy Spirit is saying to you? He's warning you. You're insulting the Spirit of grace. The Bible says, if we sin willfully, after receiving the knowledge of God, there's no more sacrifice for sins. There's no sacrifice for sins when you continue to look at porn. You're sinning willfully. The Bible says that you trample the Son of God underfoot. You trample the Son of God underfoot. You got the blood of the covenant by which you were saved, a common thing, and you insult the Spirit of grace. Spirit of grace. It's the gracious Spirit of God that you wouldn't die in your rebellion. You know, but people, they don't fear God. You're not fearing the living God, the one whose eyes are as flames of fire, his feet as burst, brass as clay, with dipped in blood. He is going to tread the fierceness of the wrath of Almighty God. He's going to tread it. Will it be you trampled underfoot on the day of judgment because you wouldn't repent? Because you wouldn't seek his face? His loving kindness is forever. His faithfulness endures forever. I'm a partaker of the tree of life, which is in the midst of the paradise of God. Yeah, you're not partaking of the tree of life out here. You're feeding on wickedness, your own wickedness. You're strengthening yourself in your own wickedness. That's what the Bible says. Lo, this is the man who made not God his strength. But it says he trusted in his own wealth, and it says he strengthened himself in his own wickedness. Man, oh man, oh man, what a terrifying thing on the day of judgment. And people, they have nothing to sustain them. When they die, they can't breathe. There's going to be no drug use in hell. There's going to be no drunkenness in hell. You're going to have no arms in hell. You're going to be burning. I'm concerned for you. What should you do? You should repent. Honor Jesus as King. Look to the King, the risen King. All the Bible says, for you know that Jesus Christ was raised from the dead, and he will present us with Jesus, and you also with us. That all things are for your sakes, that grace having spread through the many may cause thanksgiving to abound to the glory of God. There's thanksgiving when you receive grace. When you repent of your homosexuality, when you repent of your lies, when you repent of your greediness, there's mercy. Mercy waiting for you. Cleansing power of God. When God comes in, pardoning your iniquities, giving you a second chance. But right now, you don't want that. You don't want Jesus Christ to come in and come close to you. He, the friend that sticks closer than a brother. Jesus said, you did not choose me, but I chose you. And I appointed you to go and bear fruit that your fruit should remain. Your fruit's not going to remain. Your fruit's not going to remain. That's what the Bible says. The Bible says, when you die in your sin and you can't practice your homosexuality, you know, the Bible says that the fruit that they so long for is gone from them. All the things that are rich and splendid are gone from them. They'll find them no more at all. No more. Be no more on that day. What's going to be on that day? Weeping and wailing, and gnashing of teeth. The Bible says, it says, "For therefore thus says the Lord God, behold, I lay in Zion a sure stone, a tried stone, a precious cornerstone, and whoever believes on him will not act hastily. And I will make justice the measuring line and righteousness the plummet. The hail will sweep away the refuge of lies. The waters will overflow the hiding places. Your covenant with death will be annulled. Your agreement with Sheol will not stand. Now when the overflowing scourge passes through, then you'll be trampled down by it," said the prophet. Yeah, man, the overflowing scourge, the day of judgment. You're eating the fruit of your labors when you have to pay the penalty of your sin. Oh, you know, I didn't come out here because I want you to be condemned. You're already condemned. You're already condemned in your sin. But Jesus said, "Whoever believes in me is not condemned. And whoever does not believe, it says he has that which condemns him. The word that I speak will condemn him in the last day." He said, "This is the condemnation. Light came into the world. Men love darkness rather than the light because their deeds were evil. Everyone practicing evil doesn't come to the light, lest their deeds be exposed. Come to the light as he is in the light. Look, I have the same spirit of faith, according to what is written. I believe, therefore I spoke. We also believe and therefore speak." I speak these things to you. Yeah, man. Yeah, you understand. The Bible says, "For our light affliction, which is but for a moment, is working for us a far more exceeding and eternal weight of glory." The glory of a Christian, a born-again Christian. Yeah, weeping endures for a night, but joy comes in the morning. I receive from the Lord's hand. I receive forgiveness, healing, reconciliation from God. All things are of God, who has reconciled us to himself through Jesus Christ. And he has committed to us the ministry of reconciliation. That is, that God was in Christ, reconciling the whole world to himself, not imputing their trespasses to them. And he has given us the word of reconciliation. Yeah, now then we are ambassadors of Christ, as though God were pleading us, pleading to you through us. We implore you on Christ's behalf, be reconciled to God. You gotta be reconciled to God. We're pleading with you. We're pouring out our hearts to you. We're serving you. I'm serving you, my neighbor. I love my neighbor. I can serve my neighbor. I know the deception of your sin. I know the blindness of your heart. Your heart is blinded. If our gospel is veiled, it is veiled. It is veiled to those that are perishing, whose minds the God of this world has veiled. He has covered them, has blinded them, who don't believe. That's the light of the gospel of the glory of Christ, who is the image of God, should shine on them. For it is God who commanded light to shine in the darkness, who shone in our hearts to give the light of the knowledge of the glory of God in the face of Jesus Christ. We have these treasures in earthen vessels, that the excellence of the power may be of God and not of us. We are hard pressed on every side, yet not crushed. We are perplexed, but not in despair. We are struck down, but not destroyed. We are persecuted. Oh yeah, I'm persecuted, but I'm not forsaken by God. I'm chastened, but I'm not killed. Always caring about, in the body, the dying of the Lord Jesus, that the life of Jesus might be manifested in our bodies. So then death is working in us, but life in you. Death. Oh, I gotta pour out everything that somebody might escape. Their Satanism. Somebody might escape. They're worshiping of devils. You are a grumbler, a complainer. The Bible says these people are grumblers, they're complainers, they walk about according to their own lusts, while they mouth great swelling words, flattering people to gain advantage. Flattering people to gain advantage. You know, that's what's out here, a bunch of flattering tongues, a bunch of people trying to take advantage of each other, having sex with the people, not strangers. That's what Jude warned about. He said they're sensual to people. These things are earthly, sensual, and demonic. Demonic! You want to be overcome by demons? Do you really want those demons in your life? Or do you want Jesus Christ to forgive you of your sins, to cleanse you of your unrighteousness, to clean up your mouth, to clean up your cursing, your lying, your blasphemies? While they speak great smelling words of emptiness, they allure through the lust of the flesh, through uncleanness. The ones who have actually escaped those who live in error, While they promise them liberty, they themselves are slaves of corruption. But by whom a man is overcome, by him he is also brought into bondage. You're being brought into bondage. You're being overcome by the devil, false teachers. People try to teach you the Bible, it's okay for you to continue in your wicked ways. Oh, no. The Bible says this. If my people, who are called by my name, would humble themselves and pray and seek my face and turn from their wicked ways, then the Lord would hear from heaven, forgive their sins, and heal the land. You get no healing. You get no forgiveness. You get no answer from God until you seek the living God, till you turn from your wicked ways, till you pray to God with a pure heart. Oh, yeah, such is pure in their hearts. Oh, yeah, do good to those who are good, to such as are upright in their hearts. But to those who turn aside to their crooked ways, the Lord, God, the Almighty, Jesus, here will lead them away with the workers of iniquity. He'll lead you away. He'll put a bridle on your mouth. Well, the Bible says, do not be like the horse or like the mule, which have no understanding, which must be harnessed with bit and bridle, else they will not come near to me. Many sorrows will be to the wicked, and those who forsake the Lord, they'll be consumed. They'll be consumed. Man, oh man. You don't think that God has the right to execute the fierceness of his anger on the enemies of God, on the enemies of the cross of Christ? The Bible says this, join in and follow in our example. Follow my example, and note those who so walk, as you have us for a pattern. For many walk, as I told you in times past, and I tell you now even weeping, their enemies are the cross of Christ. Their end is destruction. Their God is their belly. Their glory is in their shame. They set their mind on earthly things. But our citizenship is in heaven, from which we eagerly wait for the manifestation, for the revelation of the Son of God, who will transform our lowly bodies to be conformed into his glorious body, even as by the power with which he is able to subdue all things to himself, Christ. Christ is able to subdue you in hell, subdue you in death. Yeah, you're going to acknowledge. The Bible says every tongue will confess. Everybody will swear an oath, it says in Isaiah. They will say, surely in God I have righteousness. Surely in God is my salvation and righteousness. For there is no righteousness apart from God. There is nothing good. There's nothing good in you without Jesus Christ guiding you. Jesus said, I am the true vine. My Father is the vine dresser. Every branch in me that does not bear fruit, he takes away. Every branch that bears fruit, he prunes, and it may bear more fruit. You're already clean because of the word that I've spoken to you. Oh, abide in me and I in you, as the branch cannot bear fruit of itself. Neither can you unless you abide in the vine. Jesus said, I am the vine. You are the branches. He who abides in me, he will bear much fruit. For without me, you can do nothing. Jesus said, without him, you can do nothing. If anyone does not abide in me, Jesus said, he's cast out as a branch and is withered. And they gather them and throw them into the fire, and they are burned. You're going to be gathered and thrown into the fire, Jesus said, and burned. Oh, but Jesus said, if you abide in me, and my words abide in you, you will ask what you desire, and it will be done for you. By this, my Father will be well pleased, that you bear much fruit, and so you will be my disciples. Are you bearing much fruit out here in Jesus' disciple? I think not. I'm warning you. I'm warning you about your deceptive, wicked lesbianism. You're wicked in the sight of God. Gay is not okay.
Hey. Just pull us out. I'm going to walk around a little bit.
Well, how long? How long will you simple ones love simplicity? Scorners delight in scorning and fools hate now, as the Bible says. Holy Spirit says, turn to my rebuke and surely I'll pour out my spirit on you. I'll make my words known to you. But because I stretched out my hand and no one regarded, because I reached out to you, I called to you and you did not answer. Therefore it says, I will laugh at you when your calamity comes. When your destruction comes like desolation. When your fear comes like a whirlwind. Oh, then you will call upon God and he will not answer. You will seek him early, but you'll not be found of him. He will not be found of you because you disdained his every rebuke. You didn't choose the fear of God. Oh, God. God's going to hide his face from you. God doesn't want to destroy you in hell. God doesn't want to abandon you and forsake the works of his hands. You're fearfully and wonderfully made. You're created in God's image to be a woman, to be a mother, to be a daughter, to be a sister, to be a, you know, to be what God made you. The Bible says, wash yourselves and make yourselves clean. Put away the evil of your doings from before my eyes. Cease to do evil. Learn to do good. Rebuke the oppressor. Defend the fatherless. Plead for the widow. Plead for the widow. Oh, come now, let us reason together. Though your sins be like scarlet, they shall be like wool. Though they are red like crimson, they shall be as wool. If you are willing and obedient, you'll eat the good of the land. But if you continue to refuse and rebel, you'll be devoured by the sword. For the mouth of the Lord has spoken it, Isaiah said. Oh, yeah. Yeah, God spoke. God spoke, the earth trembled. Oh, yeah. Yeah, you know what God said? God said this. God said, here, I'm loving you. The Bible's love. The scriptures are love. You're not receiving the love of God. Yes, I am. I'm quoting you straight from the Bible. You can't fault me for doing that. I'm quoting to you scriptures. Why don't you love the Bible? Why don't you love the truth? You know how you love the Lord? You have a heart for the Word of God. Isaiah chapter 1. Open your Bible to it. Hear, O heavens, give ear, O earth. The ox knows its owner and the donkey its master's crib. But Israel does not know, nor do my people consider. They don't consider. Alas, sinful nation, a people laden with iniquity, a brood of evildoers, children who are corruptors. They have forsaken the Lord. They have provoked to anger the Holy One of Israel. They have turned away backwards. Why should you be stricken again? You will revolt more and more. The whole head is sick. The whole heart faints. From the sole of the foot, even to the head, there's no soundness in it. But wounds and bruises and putrefying sores. They have not been bound up. They have not been bound nor closed up nor soothed with ointment. Your country is desolate. Your cities are burned with fire. Strangers devour your land in your presence. And it is desolate as overthrown by strangers. Oh yeah. Zion is left as a booth in a vineyard, as a hut in the garden of cucumbers, as a besieged city. Unless the Lord would have left us a very small remnant, we would have become like Sodom. We would have been made like Gomorrah. Unless the Lord would have left a remnant, we would have become like Sodom. We would have been made like Gomorrah. Hear the word of the Lord, you people of Sodom. Give ear to the law of our God, you people of Gomorrah. To what purpose is the multitude of your sacrifices to me, says the Lord? I do not delight in the burnt offerings of rams or the fat of fed cattle. I have had enough of your sacrifices of blood of bulls, of goats, lambs. No, when you come to appear before me, who has required this from your hand to trample my courts? Bring no more futile sacrifices. Incense is an abomination to me. The new moons, the Sabbaths, the calling of assemblies, I cannot endure iniquity in the sacred meeting. God can't endure it. Your sacrifices, your church services that you go to, God is, he says they are a burden to him. He's weary of bearing them. It says his soul hates them. Oh, man. Oh, man. God's going to rise up. God's going to rise up against the house of evildoers and against the hand of those who help those who work iniquity. All the people out here allowing these homosexuals to work iniquity, even then, they're going to be condemned together. They're going to be condemned together. Why won't you be the example? Why won't you come out? Why won't you stand for God? Why won't you make a stand? Who will stand for me against the evildoers? Who will rise for me against the workers of iniquity? Look, in the multitude of my anxieties, I say, your comforts delight my soul. His comforts delight my soul. I won't fear the wicked. I won't fear when men rise up against the Lord and try to change his ways. You need to change your ways. You need to repent. If you don't repent, Jesus said you're going to perish. You're going to be destroyed. But there's love. The mercy of God, he knows. He knows the pain and the shame and the guilt. He knows the destruction of sinners and transgressors shall be together, and those who forsake the Lord shall be consumed. For they shall be ashamed of your terebinth trees, which you have desired. Yeah, you'll be embarrassed of the gardens that you have chosen, because you shall be as a terebinth tree whose leaf fades, and as a garden that has no water. The mighty, the strong, it says they'll burn like tinder, and the spark, they'll just be burned up. No one shall quench that, they'll burn forever.